Hello to all furniture designers, manufacturers, and enthusiasts. In this video, I will explain how to design your own hardware so that it can be recognized and correctly interpreted by the JoinerCAD BOM generator. There are two ways to design such hardware. First, the user can create the hardware from scratch using standard Fusion 360 tools. Second, the user may import it from third-party libraries. In both cases, such hardware will need to be properly processed by assigning certain attributes. First, using standard Fusion 360 tools, I upload the geometry of the hardware element, that is, step file, and open it for further processing. Then I change the solid bodies that comprise this geometry into components, join them together in a rigid group, and by using the ground command, I make them stationary. To make it clearer which component is which, I will give specific names and change the appearance of the components. This also improves their visual expressiveness. Half of the work is already done. Now I have to assign information to the parts, that is, material group or hardware description. This is needed for the element to be processed in the JoinerCAD environment and to be correctly represented in the generated BOM. Otherwise, element information will not be included in the JoinerCAD BOM, as you can see now in this example. I select the first hardware element and right-click to open the BOM management window. I give the element a code, enter a description, and select BOM structure. The BOM structure determines how the element will be interpreted in the JoinerCAD BOM. Three BOM structure options are available. First, if you select Normal, the component will not be included in the JoinerCAD BOM until a JoinerCAD material is assigned to it. Second, if Quantitative is selected, the component will be interpreted by the JoinerCAD BOM as a solid purchased element. Finally, if you select Translucent, such a component will not be shown in the JoinerCAD BOM, but all elements of an assembly will be moved one level up and shown separately. In our case, I specify both elements as purchased. In other words, Quantitative. And enter codes and chosen names. Then, the assembly composed of these two elements is specified as translucent. This way, it will not be shown in BOM, and its constituent elements will be moved up and shown separately. The hardware is ready for further use and only needs to be inserted at a desired location of the designed model. I will do this using standard Fusion 360 tools. Using the joints, I specify the precise location where the hardware has to be inserted and select the rigid type joint so that it cannot move from its position in the model. More tutorials on inserting hardware are available in other videos of our JoinerCAD YouTube channel. Once the hardware is inserted in the designed model, we have to generate the JoinerCAD BOM. As you can see, inserted components are shown as individual elements rather than an assembly. The hardware adaptation for work in JoinerCAD is complete. Good luck!